będzie pochwalony Jezus Chrystus. Witamy serdecznie pielgrzymów polskich. Oprócz osób i rodzin, które przybyły indywidualnie, są tu obecni. Pielgrzymi z diecezji włocławskiej. Pielgrzymi z Gniezna, Łodzi, Poznania, Warszawy, Opola, Krakowa, Katowic, Kłodzka, Leszna, Szczecina, Bydgoszczy oraz przedstawiciele Polonii z Niemiec. Nauczyciele i uczniowie liceum sióstr prezentek imienia świętego Jana Pawła II w Rzeszowie, którzy przybyli z okazji 25-lecia istnienia tegoż liceum. Uczniowie i wychowawcy z klasycznego liceum ogólnokształcącego w Skierniewicach. Pielgrzymi z diecezji koszalińsko-kołobrzeskiej, z Kołobrzegu, Piły i Biesiekierza. Pielgrzymi z miejscowości Kębło koło Wolsztyna. Pielgrzymi z parafii pod wezwaniem Najświętszej Maryi Panny Nieustającej Pomocy we Wrocławiu. Szczególnie serdecznie witamy i pozdrawiamy pary nowożeńców. Przygotowując się na spotkanie z Ojcem Świętym, przypominamy, że bilety wstępu na audiencję są zawsze darmowe i wydawane wyłącznie przez prefekturę Domu Papieskiego. Ponadto informujemy, że po zakończeniu audiencji dla chętnych będzie możliwość uczestniczenia we mszy świętej dla pielgrzymów odprawianej w Bazylice Świętego Piotra. Jego świątobliwość znakiem krzyża i pozdrowieniem liturgicznym rozpocznie za chwilę to
słowo. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ. And welcome to this live-streamed broadcast of Pope Francis's general audience of Wednesday, October 5th, 2022. My name is Christopher Wells, and I'll be providing the English language commentary for this morning's audience. Whether you're joining us through the various Vatican media channels, the Vatican audio or radio app, the Vatican News web portal, or our Vatican News web portal or YouTube channel, or via one of our partner stations, including Luminous Radio, Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, Radio Maria England, Radio Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, Atmadarshan TV, EWTN TV, or Catholic TV. A very warm welcome, one and all. Pope Francis is expected to continue his new catechetical series on discernment, reflecting today on the example, reflecting today on the elements of discernment, beginning with knowing oneself. Holy Father will begin the audience, as usual, with the sign of the cross and the liturgical greeting, after which we'll hear the scriptural passage chosen for the day's reflection. Today's passage is taken from the Old Testament book of Sirach, chapter 17, verses 1 and verses 6 and 7. After the reading is proclaimed in multiple languages, Pope Francis will give his catechesis in Italian. We'll translate that into English for you. After the catechesis, the Pope greets pilgrims and visitors in various major languages. For each language, a speaker gives a greeting to the Holy Father and then a summary of the catechesis in their own language. Pope Francis then says a few words of greeting in Italian, which are then translated into the various languages. We'll offer a translation of the greetings, although not the summaries, as the summaries are essentially the same for each of the various languages. The general audience concludes with the recitation in Latin of the Our Father, followed by the Pope's apostolic blessing, which is extended not only to those present, but to everyone following the audience live. The Holy Father is currently making the rounds of St. Peter's Square on a beautiful, slightly cool October morning in Rome, kissing babies and giving them his blessing. As is fairly usual, while we have a band playing for the Holy Father as he arrives. It is common at the audiences. Of course, there are tens of thousands of people present each week, especially when the audience is held in St. Peter's Square. And many people come in groups, often attired in their traditional outfits or their uniforms for their bands or choirs or organizations. And there's routinely at least a few musical groups that will perform one or two pieces for our Holy Father, which we hear in the background now. Also, usually quite a few flags in the crowd. We've seen a number of Ukrainian flags already this morning. And as the Pope makes his way through the square, many people have an opportunity to see him up close. And the security guards, as we already mentioned, will periodically help a little child to the Holy Father. The Holy Father will take them in his arms and usually give them a kiss and a little blessing. It's a wonderful opportunity for parents, and when the children are a little bit older, will be a wonderful memorial of their opportunity to see the Pope. Now we see the Holy Father in the Pope Mobile yet, driving up the platform in front of St. Peter's Basilica. For those watching on television, you can see the Holy Father's throne is set up so he can be seen throughout the square. On either side, there are groups of people, including the bishops and cardinals, present for the audience. Among those present for the various audiences each week, there's usually a special section set aside for recently married couples. Another wonderful opportunity for people at significant moments of their lives to see up close our Holy Father. And they come dressed in their wedding attire. It's very easy to request from the papal household tickets for the audience if you happen to be in Rome. And if you have been married in the last couple of months, they are happy to provide tickets for the special section for newlyweds. The Holy Father is making his way slowly to his throne. As is well known, the Holy Father has been having trouble with his knee. He's spoken about that himself many times, so he does move about a little bit more slowly. And we do offer prayers for his recovery. Now you see Polish flags waving in the background. And again, in a moment, we'll begin our general audience for today, Wednesday, October 5th, 2022. Those of you listening in on the radio, you hear the round of applause as the Holy Father reaches his throne. And he will begin now with the sign of the cross and the liturgical greeting, peace be with you.
Il Santo Padre da ora inizia l'udienza generale, introducendola con il segno della croce e il saluto liturgico. Disponiamoci ad accogliere la sua parola e a ricevere la sua benedizione.
Nel nome del Padre, del Figlio e dello Spirito Santo. La pace sia con voi.
And now we'll hear the scriptural passage chosen for today's audience in the various major languages, beginning with Italian.
Il Signore creò l'uomo dalla terra e ad essa di nuovo lo fece tornare. Discernimento, lingua, occhi, orecchi e cuore diede loro per pensare. Li riempì di scienza ed intelligenza e mostrò loro sia il bene che il male. È parola di Dio.
Du livre de Ben Sira le Sage. Le Seigneur a créé l'homme en le tirant de la terre et il l'a fait retourner à la terre. Aux humains, il a donné du jugement, une langue, des yeux, des oreilles et un cœur pour réfléchir. Il les a remplis de savoir et d'intelligence. Il leur a fait connaître le bien et le mal. Parole du Seigneur.
A reading from the Book of Sirach. The Lord created human beings out of earth and makes them return to it again. Discretion and tongue, and eyes, ears, and a mind for thinking he gave them. He filled them with knowledge and understanding, and showed them good and evil. The word of the Lord.
Lesung aus dem Buch Jesus Sirach. Der Herr hat aus Erde den Menschen geschaffen und zu ihr lässt er ihn wieder zurückkehren. Entscheidungsfähigkeit, Sprache und Ohren, Augen, Ohren und Herz hat er ihnen gegeben, um zu denken. Er füllte sie mit Wissen und Einsicht. Gutes und Böses hat er ihnen gezeigt. Wort des lebendigen Gottes.
Lectura del libro del Eclesiástico. El Señor creó al hombre de la tierra y lo hace volver de nuevo a ella. Le dio una lengua, ojos y oídos, el poder de discernir y un corazón para pensar. Él colmó a los hombres de saber y entendimiento y les mostró el bien y el mal. Palabra de Dios.
Leitura do livro de Ben-Sirá. O Senhor criou os homens a partir da terra e a ela de novo os faz voltar. Dotou-os de inteligência, língua e olhos, de ouvidos e de um coração para pensar. Encheu-os de saber e de inteligência e mostrou-lhes o bem e o mal. Palavra do Senhor.
And now we'll have just one or two more readings, and the Holy Father will begin his audience.
خلق الرب الإنسان من الأرض وإليها أعاده وأعطاهم عقلا ولسانا وعينين وأذنين وقلبا للتفكير وملأهم من العلم والفطنة وأطلعهم على الخير والشر كلام الرب.
Czytanie z Księgi Mądrości Syracha. Pan stworzył człowieka z ziemi i znów go jej zwróci. Dał ludziom wolną wolę, język i oczy, uszy i serce zdolne do myślenia. Napełnił ich wiedzą i rozumem, o złu i dobru ich pouczył. Oto Słowo Boże.
Now the words of our Holy Father.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning.
Continuiamo.
We continue to deal with the theme of discernment. Last time we considered prayer as an indispensable element, and prayer understood as familiarity and confidence with God as its indispensable element, not like repeating words like a parrot. This is what we saw in our last catechesis. Today, I'd like, in a somewhat complementary manner, to emphasize the good discernment also requires knowledge of self, knowing yourself,
questo non è facile.
And this is not easy.
Esso infatti coinvolge le nostre facoltà umane, la memoria, l'intelletto.
Indeed, it involves our human faculties, memory, intellect, will, affections. Often we do not know how to discern because we do not know ourselves well enough. And so we do not know what we really want. And we've heard many times. And that people don't know what they really want. This may be a little bit extreme, but it happens to some degree in each one of us. Underlying spiritual doubts and vocational crises is not infrequently an insufficient dialogue between religious life and our human, cognitive, and affective dimensions. A writer on spirituality noted how many difficulties on the theme of discernment are indicative of problems of another kind, which must be recognized and explored. This author writes, "I have come to the conviction that the greatest obstacle to true discernment and to real growth in prayer is not the intangible nature of God, but the fact that we do not know ourselves sufficiently and do not even want to know ourselves as we really are. Almost all of us hide behind a mask, not only in front of others, but also when we look in a mirror. We have a tendency to wear a mask even in front of ourselves. Forgetfulness of God's presence in our life goes hand in hand with ignorance of ourselves. Our personality traits and our deepest desires. Knowing oneself is not difficult, but it is laborious. It implies patient soul-searching. It requires the capacity to stop, to turn off the autopilot, to acquire awareness of our way of acting, of the feelings that dwell within us, of the recurring thoughts that condition us, often unconsciously. It also requires that we distinguish between emotions and spiritual faculties. I feel is not the same as I am convinced. I feel like it's not the same as I want. Thus we come to recognize that the view we have of ourselves and of reality is at times somewhat distorted. To realize this is a grace. Indeed, very often it can happen that erroneous convictions about reality based on past experiences strongly influence us, limiting our freedom to strive for what really matters in our lives. Living in the age of information technology, we know how important it is to know the password in order to get into the programs where the most personal and valuable information is stored. Spiritual life, too, has its passwords. They're words that touch the heart because they refer to what we are most sensitive to. The tempter knows these passwords well, and it is important that we know them too, so as not to find ourselves where we do not want to be. Temptation does not necessarily suggest bad things, but often disordered things presented with excessive importance. In this way, it hypnotizes us with the attraction that these things stir up in us, things that are beautiful but illusory, that cannot deliver what they promise, leaving us in the end with a sense of emptiness and sadness. This sense at times that we have gone along a path that is not right, and we end up disoriented. They can be degrees, careers, relationships, all things that are in themselves praiseworthy, but towards which, if we are not free, we risk harboring unrealistic expectations, such as confirmation of our own worth. You, for example, when you think about the studies that you're doing, you can think about promoting yourself. From this misunderstanding often comes the greatest suffering, because none of those things can be the guarantee of our dignity. That's why, dear brothers and sisters, it's important to know oneself, to know the passwords of our heart, what we are most sensitive to, in order to protect ourselves from those who present themselves with persuasive words to manipulate us, but also to recognize what is truly important for us, distinguishing it from current fads or flashy, superficial slogans. Oftentimes, you could say, the Holy Father says, beware of things that are trying to manipulate you. An aid in this is an examination of conscience. This is not like the examination you do before confession. This is more of a general reflection on the day. What happened in my heart today, on this day? What happened throughout the day? Why did it happen? Make this exam of conscience. It's a good habit to reflect at the end of the day on what happened during the day. An aid in this examination of conscience, that is the good habit of calmly rereading what happens in our day, learning to note in our evaluations and choices what we give most importance to, what we're looking for and why, and what we eventually find. Above all, learning to recognize what satiates the heart, for only the Lord can give us confirmation of what we are worth. He tells us this every day from the cross. He died for us to show us how precious we are in His eyes. There is no obstacle or failure that can prevent His tender embrace. The examination of conscience is good for everyone. We have to see what's happening in our hearts. What's made me happy or sad? What's bad or good the past through our hearts in the day?
Non dimenticatevi, l'altro giorno abbiamo parlato della preghiera, oggi parliamo della conoscenza di se stessi. La preghiera e la conoscenza di se stessi.
Prayer and self-knowledge enable us to grow in freedom.
Questo è per crescere nella libertà. Sono elementi basici.
They are basic elements of Christian existence and precious elements for finding one's place in life. Thank you. Our Holy Father's reflection for today on discernment, the second major element of discernment that he's spoken of. Last week he spoke about prayer, as he reminded us, and now talking about This morning, self-knowledge. Now we hear the greetings from the various languages, beginning with French. As we mentioned, the speaker greets the Holy Father and turns and gives a summary of this morning's audience. We do not translate the audience. We do not translate the summary, as I mentioned, because they're basically the same in each language, and simply summarize what we just heard. However, we will give a translation of the greetings. After the summary, the Holy Father says a few words in Italian addressed to speakers of the various languages. The speaker will then translate the Holy Father's greetings, and we will translate that into English for you.
Il faut aussi une connaissance de soi. Nous ne savons pas discerner souvent parce que nous ne nous connaissons pas suffisamment et ne savons pas non plus ce que nous voulons vraiment. Pour se connaître, il faut faire un travail intérieur patient pour nous scruter, être capable de s'arrêter pour prendre conscience de notre façon de faire et des sentiments qui nous habitent, savoir distinguer les émotions et les facultés spirituelles. C'est ainsi seulement qu'il est possible de se rendre compte à quel point la vision que nous avons de nous-mêmes et de la réalité est parfois erronée. Il est important dans la vie spirituelle, à l'image de l'informatique, d'avoir ces mots de passe. Ce sont des paroles qui touchent le cœur et renvoient à ce à quoi nous sommes les plus sensibles. Le tentateur connaît bien ces mots-clés et il nous suggère souvent des choses désordonnées, présentées avec une importance excessive, qui nous laisse dans des sentiments de vide et de tristesse. C'est pour cela qu'il est important de nous connaître avec les mots de passe de notre cœur afin de nous protéger et de savoir ce qui est vraiment important pour nous. L'examen de conscience est une aide car il nous permet d'apprendre à reconnaître ce qui comble vraiment le cœur. La prière et la connaissance de soi permettent à chacun de grandir dans la liberté et de trouver sa vraie place dans la vie. Maintenant, le Saint-Père va saluer en italien les fidèles de langue française.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini di lingua francese, particolare i fedeli della diocesi di Metz e i giovani del Collegio San Giuseppe. Fratelli e sorelle, in questo mese di preghiera per le missioni impariamo a coltivare momenti di silenzio e di incontro con il Signore perché ci ispiri le vie e i mezzi per essere sempre fedeli alla nostra vocazione di discepoli missionari. Dio vi benedica.
Vous saluons en
italien. I cordially greet the French-speaking pilgrims, in particular the faithful of the Diocese of Metz and the young people of St. Joseph's College. Brothers and sisters, in this month of prayer for the missions, let us learn to cultivate moments of silence and encounter with the Lord, so that He may inspire us with ways and means to be ever faithful to our vocation as missionary disciples. God bless you. And now we'll hear the exchange of greetings and summary in English.
Most Holy Father, the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors wish to express to you their sentiments of deep respect and esteem, and to assure you of their prayers for your ministry as the successor of Peter. At the end of the audience, we will sing together the Our Father in Latin. His Holiness will then impart his apostolic blessing, which he extends in a particular way to the members of your families at home. He also intends to bless any religious articles you may have brought for this purpose, And in a special way, his blessing goes to your children, the elderly, and those who are sick. The following is a summary of the Holy Father's catechesis at the beginning of the audience. Dear brothers and sisters, in our continuing catechesis on spiritual discernment, we have considered the essential importance of growth in prayer. Today, we consider, as a necessary complement to prayer, our need to grow in self-knowledge. Coming to know ourselves is not easy. It requires honesty and a patient descent into the depths of our heart. Self-knowledge is itself a fruit of God's grace, whereby we are led to abandon our illusions, to understand who we really are, and to embrace the things that can bring us genuine happiness. In effect, we learn the passwords that open the portal to our deepest self and the paths that can lead us to lasting spiritual joy and fulfillment in obedience to God's gracious will. A great help to such prayerful insight into ourselves and thus to authentic discernment is the traditional practice of the nightly examination of conscience. Through daily prayer and self-knowledge, may we more readily discern the Lord's plan for our lives and come to appreciate more fully our dignity and freedom as beloved children of our Heavenly Father. The Holy Father will now greet us in Italian.
Do il benvenuto a tutti i pellegrini di lingua inglese presenti nell'odierna udienza, specialmente quelli provenienti da Scozia, Norvegia, Svezia, Australia, India, Vietnam e Stati Uniti. Rivolgo un saluto particolare ai nuovi studenti del Pontificio Collegio Beda e ai membri dell'Associazione Cattolica di Predicatori dall'Inghilterra. Su tutti voi invoco la gioia e la pace di Cristo nostro Signore. Dio vi benedica.
I greet the English-speaking pilgrims taking part in today's audience, especially those from England, Scotland, Norway, Sweden, Australia, India, Vietnam, and the United States of America. I offer a special greeting to the new seminarians from the Pontifical Beda College and to the Catholic Association of Preachers from England. Upon all of you, I invoke the joy and peace of Christ our Lord. God bless you.
We continue now with German.
Heiliger Vater, die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache möchten Ihnen ihre herzliche Zuneigung und aufrichtige Verbundenheit bekunden und versichern Sie zugleich Ihres Gebets in allen Anliegen Ihres universalen apostolischen Dienstes. Zum Schluss dieser Audienz singen wir gemeinsam das Vater Unser in lateinischer Sprache. Danach wird der Heilige Vater den apostolischen Segen erteilen. Gern schließt er darin ihre Angehörigen ein, besonders die Kinder, die älteren Menschen und die Leidenden. Er segnet auch die Rosenkränze und die übrigen Andachtsgegenstände, die sie dafür mitgebracht haben. Es folgt nun eine Zusammenfassung der Katechese des Heiligen Vaters in deutscher Sprache. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern, heute möchte ich mit euch über ein weiteres Element sprechen, das wesentlich ist für eine gute Unterscheidung der Geister, über die Selbsterkenntnis. Viele Schwierigkeiten, auch im geistlichen Leben, liegen darin begründet, dass wir uns nicht wirklich selber kennen und dies manchmal auch gar nicht ernsthaft wollen. Gern verstecken wir uns hinter Masken, vor den anderen und auch vor uns selbst. Zu einer guten Selbsterkenntnis zu gelangen, ist an sich nicht schwer, aber bisweilen ganz schön mühsam. Verlangt es doch, das eigene Innere zu erforschen. Dazu muss man innehalten, das eigene Handeln reflektieren, sich seinen Gefühlen stellen, die Herkunft einiger stets wiederkehrender Gedanken ergründen und vieles mehr. Man stellt dabei fest, dass die eigene Selbst- und Wirklichkeitswahrnehmung bisweilen ein wenig verzerrt ist. Das zu erkennen ist eine Gnade. Auch eine regelmäßige Gewissenserforschung kann helfen, die Ereignisse des Tages zu prüfen, zu ordnen und immer besser zu erkennen, was unseren unruhigen Herzen wirklich Erfüllung schenkt, nämlich die Gewissheit, dass der Herr uns liebt und wir für ihn wertvoll sind. Das Gebet und die Selbsterkenntnis helfen uns, innerlich frei zu werden, im geistlichen Leben zu wachsen und unseren Platz im Leben zu finden. Der Heilige Vater richtet nun einen kurzen Gruß auf Italienisch an die deutschsprachigen Gläubigen.
Saluto con affetto i pellegrini di lingua tedesca, in particolare i chierichetti di Colonia. Come pure i partecipanti alla settimana informativa della Guardia Svizzera Pontificia. Auguro a voi, giovani, un buon soggiorno, spiritualmente fruttuoso a Roma. Signore, vi aiuti tutti a crescere nell'amore e vi protegga sempre.
Der Heilige Vater sagte: Herzlich grüße ich die Pilger in deutscher Sprache, insbesondere die Ministranten aus dem Erzbistum.
I greet with affection the German-speaking pilgrims, in particular the altar boys from the Archdiocese of Cologne with their Archbishop, Cardinal Wilke, as well as the participants of the Pontifical Swiss Guard Information Week. I wish you young people a good and spiritually fruitful stay in Rome. May the Lord help you to grow in love and protect you always. The Holy Father will now speak in Spanish, because the Spanish is his native language. The Holy Father, after the greeting, will give the summary himself. Again, we will not translate that. But then he will offer his greeting to the Spanish speakers, and that will be translated into English for you.
Al final de este encuentro se cantará el Padre Nuestro en latín. Después, Su Santidad impartirá a todos los presentes la bendición apostólica, que extiende complacido a sus familiares, especialmente a los niños y a los ancianos, a los enfermos y a cuantos sufren. Bendice también los rosarios y objetos de devoción que los peregrinos llevan consigo.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, seguimos reflexionando sobre el tema del discernimiento. Para discernir es importante, además de rezar, que nos conozcamos a nosotros mismos. Conocerse a sí mismo, nuestra personalidad, nuestros deseos más profundos, puede resultar fatigoso, pero aunque cueste, el hecho de detenernos y profundizar en lo que hacemos, sentimos y pensamos, nos ayuda a caer en la cuenta de todo aquello que nos condiciona y que limita nuestra libertad para dar la vida por Cristo y ser así verdaderamente felices. Un instrumento muy valioso para conocerse a sí mismo es hacer cada día el examen de conciencia, ver lo que pasó por mi corazón ese día. Esta buena costumbre consiste en releer con calma todo lo que vivimos durante la jornada, reconociendo lo que nos seduce y lo que nos engaña, y distinguiéndolo de aquello que es realmente importante y bueno para nosotros. Ese paciente trabajo interior nos ayuda a integrar todas las dimensiones de nuestra vida y a vivir con autenticidad en la presencia de Dios. Saludo cordialmente a los peregrinos de lengua española.
I cordially greet the Spanish-speaking pilgrims. Let us ask Jesus. Let us ask Jesus to teach us to pray in order to know his heart and to help us to know ourselves. And this way we will be able, with his grace, to follow in his footsteps with freedom and simplicity of heart. May God bless you, and may the Holy Virgin watch over you. Thank you very much. After Spanish, we'll hear Portuguese.
Santo Padre, os fiéis de língua portuguesa desejam testemunhar-lhe filial afeto e sincera fidelidade e rezam por todas as intenções do seu ministério apostólico universal. No final desta audiência, cantaremos a oração do Pai Nosso em latim. Depois, o Santo Padre concederá a bênção apostólica com um pensamento especial às crianças, aos idosos e aos doentes. Abençoará também os terços e demais objetos de devoção que cada um tiver consigo. Leio agora um resumo da catequese que o Santo Padre acaba de propor. Para um bom discernimento, além da oração vivida em familiaridade e confidência com Deus, requer-se o conhecimento de nós mesmos e dos nossos desejos mais profundos. Isto só se consegue com um paciente trabalho de introspeção. Para tomarmos consciência do nosso modo de agir, dos sentimentos que nos animam, dos pensamentos que frequentemente nos condicionam, mesmo sem nos darmos conta. Precisamos de aprender a distinguir entre emoções e impulsos da alma. Por exemplo, ouço, não é o mesmo que estou convencido. Como não o é, apetece-me e quero. O problema é que não nos conhecemos suficientemente e assim não sabemos aquilo que verdadeiramente queremos. Para superar tal ignorância, é de grande ajuda o exame de consciência, ou seja, aquele hábito bom de repassar calmamente aquilo que fizemos durante o dia, aprendendo a notar, nas avaliações e nas decisões, aquilo a que damos maior importância, o que procuramos conseguir e porquê, e qual foi o resultado. Aprendendo, sobretudo, a reconhecer aquilo que sacia o nosso coração. Pois o tentador nem sempre nos sugere coisas más, mas apresenta-nos-las com uma importância excessiva, hipnotizando-nos com o fascínio que as mesmas exercem sobre nós. São coisas belas, mas ilusórias, que no fim nos deixam um sentimento de vazio e tristeza. Só o Senhor é que nos pode confirmar na avaliação justa que fazemos das coisas. Fixemo-lo na cruz. Lá morreu Ele por nós, para nos mostrar quão preciosos somos a seus olhos. Não há obstáculo nem falimento que possam impedir o seu terno abraço. Agora o Santo Padre saúda em italiano os fiéis de língua portuguesa.
Cari pellegrini di lingua portoghese, benvenuti. Nel salutarvi tutti, in particolare i gruppi brasiliani di Goiânia e dell'Arquidiocese di San Paolo, nonché i fedeli portoghesi di Alcanera e della parrocchia San Paolo in Setúbal, vi invito a chiedere al Signore una grande fede per guardare la realtà con lo sguardo di Dio e una grande carità per accostarsi alle persone con il suo cuore misericordioso. Fidatevi di Dio come la Vergine Maria. Su di voi e sulle vostre famiglie scenda la benedizione del Signore.
Eis a tradução das suas palavras. Queridos peregrinos de língua portuguesa.
Dear Portuguese-speaking pilgrims, welcome. I'm greeting you all, especially the Brazilian groups from Goiânia and the Archdiocese of São Paulo as well as the Portuguese faithful from Alcanena and the parish of São Paulo in Setúbal. I invite you to ask the Lord for great faith to look at reality with God's gaze and great charity to approach people with His merciful heart. Trust in God, like the Virgin Mary. Upon you and your families, may the Lord's blessing descend.
Como a Virgem Maria, sobre vós e vossas famílias, desça a bênção do Senhor.
We'll now hear the exchange of greetings and the summary in Arabic.
أيها الأب الأقدس يسر المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية الحاضرين هنا أن يعبروا لكم عن مشاعر الاحترام والتقدير وشكرهم البنوي ويرفقونها بصلواتهم الدائمة إلى الله من أجل قداستكم وخدمتكم كخليفة القديس بطرس. في نهاية هذه المقابلة سنرتل معا صلاة الأبانا باللغة اللاتينية، ثم سيمنح الأب الأقدس جميع الحاضرين البركة الرسولية ويشمل بها جميع أحبائكم وخاصة الأطفال والمتزوجين حديثا والمسنين والمرضى والمتألمين بآلام شديدة، وسيبارك كذلك المسابح والأشياء التقوية التي يحملها معه كل واحد منكم. إليكم ملخص التعليم المسيحي لقداسة البابا فرانسيس. تكلم قداسة البابا اليوم على عنصر آخر من عناصر التمييز وهو معرفة الذات. قال: غالباً ما لا نعرف كيف نميز، لأننا لا نعرف أنفسنا جيداً بما يكفي، وبالتالي لا نعرف ماذا نريد حقاً. ونسيان حضور الله في حياتنا يسير جنباً إلى جنب مع جهل أنفسنا وخصائص شخصيتنا وأعمق رغباتنا. أن نعرف أنفسنا ليس بالأمر الصعب، لكنه أمر يتطلب بعد الجهد والتعب، يتطلب عمل تنقيب داخلي صابر، وأن نتوقف لنفكر في ما نعمل وكيف نعمل وما هي المشاعر التي تسكننا والأفكار التي تسيطر علينا ونحن غير واعين. فإذا أعدنا النظر في أنفسنا وفي أعمالنا، قد نكتشف أن نظرتنا لنفسنا أو للواقع قد تكون نظرة منحرفة، وإن أدركنا ذلك فذلك نعمة. لهذا السبب من المهم أن نعرف أنفسنا وماذا يؤثر في قلبنا وما هي الأمور الأكثر حساسية في حياتنا، ذلك حتى نحمي أنفسنا من الذين يأتون إلينا مع كلام مقنع ليخدعونا، وأيضاً لنعرف ما هو الأهم في حياتنا. يساعدنا في هذا الأمر فحص الضمير، أي أن نعيد النظر بهدوء فيما حدث في يومنا، ونتعلم أن نلاحظ ما الذي أعطيناه أهمية في تقييمنا للأمور وفي خياراتنا، وما الذي بحثنا عنه ولماذا، وماذا وجدنا في النهاية. وفوق كل شيء نتعلم أن نعرف ما الذي يروي قلبنا. الصلاة ومعرفة أنفسنا هي عناصر ثمينة لنعرف أن نميز بين الأمور ولكي نجد مكاننا في الحياة. والآن تحية البابا باللغة الإيطالية لأبناء الشرق الناطقين اللغة العربية.
Saluti fedeli di lingua araba. La preghiera e la conoscenza di se stessi sono elementi basilari della resistenza cristiana, elementi preziosi per trovare il proprio posto nella vita. Signore vi benedica tutti e vi protegga sempre da ogni male.
أحيي المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية.
I greet the Arabic-speaking faithful. Prayer and self-knowledge are basic elements of Christian existence, precious elements for finding one's place in life. May the Lord bless you all and protect you always from all evil.
Ojcze Święty, pielgrzymi z Polski i z innych krajów pragną przekazać Waszej świątobliwości wyrazy synowskiego oddania i szczerej wierności, zapewniając o modlitwie we wszystkich intencjach Jego apostolskiej posługi. Na zakończenie audiencji zaśpiewamy modlitwę Ojcze Nasz po łacinie. Po jej zakończeniu Ojciec Święty udzieli apostolskiego błogosławieństwa, obejmując nim szczególnie dzieci, osoby w podeszłym wieku i dotknięte cierpieniem. Pobłogosławi także różańce i dewocjonalia, jakie pielgrzymi przynoszą ze sobą. Oto streszczenie katechezy Ojca Świętego. W katechezach o rozeznawaniu mówiliśmy ostatnio o znaczeniu modlitwy i zażyłości z Bogiem. Dobre rozeznanie wymaga też jednak poznania samego siebie. Często nie potrafimy rozeznać, ponieważ nie znamy siebie wystarczająco dobrze i dlatego nie wiemy, czego naprawdę chcemy. Żyjąc w dobie cyfrowej, wiemy, jak ważna jest znajomość haseł, aby dostać się do programów, które zawierają cenne informacje. Życie duchowe też ma swoje hasła. Są to słowa, które poruszają serca, bo odnoszą się do tego, na co jesteśmy najbardziej wrażliwi. Kusiciel dobrze zna te słowa i ważne jest, abyśmy i my je znali. Pokusa nie musi sugerować rzeczy złych, ale często rzeczy nieuporządkowane, do których przywiązujemy nadmierną wagę. W ten sposób hipnotyzuje nas atrakcyjnością, jakie te rzeczy w nas wzbudzają. Rzeczy piękne, ale złudne, które nie mogą dostarczyć tego, co obiecują, pozostawiając nas w końcu z poczuciem pustki i smutku. Dlatego tak ważne jest poznanie siebie, poznanie haseł naszego serca, tego, na co jesteśmy najbardziej wrażliwi, aby uchronić się przed tymi, którzy się nimi posługują, by nami manipulować, ale także, aby rozpoznać, co jest dla nas naprawdę ważne. Cenną pomocą jest tym codzienny rachunek sumienia, czyli dobry nawyk spokojnego odczytywania na nowo tego, co wydarzyło się w naszym dniu, aby patrząc na nasze oceny i wybory, zrozumieć, do czego przywiązujemy największą wagę, czego szukamy i co w końcu znajdujemy, co nasyca nasze serca. Teraz Ojciec Święty pozdrowi nas, Polaków, w języku polskim, włoskim.
Saluto cordialmente i polacchi presenti in questa udienza. Oggi ricordiamo nella liturgia Santa Faustina Kowalska. Tramite lei Dio indicò al mondo di cercare la salvezza nella sua misericordia. Ricordiamolo, soprattutto oggi, pensando specialmente alla guerra in Ucraina. Come detto domenica scorsa all'Angelus, confidiamo nella misericordia di Dio che può cambiare i cuori e nella materna intercessione della Regina della Pace. Vi benedico di cuore.
Oto słowa Ojca Świętego. Pozdrawiam serdecznie.
I cordially greet the Poles present at this audience. Today we remember Saint Faustina Kowalska in the liturgy. Through her, God showed the world to seek salvation in His mercy. Let us remember this especially today, thinking especially of the war in Ukraine. As I said last Sunday at the Angelus, let us trust in God's mercy, which can change hearts, and in the maternal intercession of the Queen of Peace. I bless you from my heart. The greetings in Italian. I do not include a summary, of course, since the Holy Father gave his catechesis in Italian. And we'll await the Pope's words here in a moment.
Santo Padre,
I fedeli di lingua italiana desiderano esprimerle filiale affetto e sincera fedeltà e pregano per tutte le intenzioni del suo universale ministero apostolico. A conclusione di questa udienza canteremo la preghiera del Padre Nostro in latino, terminata la quale il Santo Padre impartirà la benedizione apostolica, che estende in modo speciale ai bambini, agli anziani e ai sofferenti. Benedirà anche i rosari e gli oggetti di devozione che ciascuno porta con sé.
I extend a cordial welcome to Italian-speaking pilgrims. In particular, I greet the faithful of the parish of St. Thomas the Apostle in Rome and those of the parish of St. James the Apostle in Grugliasco. Then I greet the representatives of Caritas of Teramo Atri, accompanied by their bishop, the Salesian Social Services Group, and the students of the Sacro Cuore School in Francavilla Fontana. I invite everyone to imitate St. Francis, patron of Italy, whose feast we celebrated yesterday. May his example of consecration to God, of service to men and women, and of fraternity with creatures guide your path. And don't forget to pray for the martyred Ukraine, always asking the Lord for the gift of peace. Finally, my thoughts go, as usual, to the young, the sick, the elderly, and to newlyweds. I urge you, too, to put yourselves in the school of the Poverello of Assisi, St. Francis, imitating him in love and contemplation of the one who is crucified, and to all my blessing. The Holy Father will now lead us in the prayer of the Our Father, followed by his apostolic benediction.
Dominum hoviscum.
Et cum spiritu.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum. Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
And the audience concludes with the Holy Father's apostolic blessing, extended, as we mentioned, not only to those present here at the audience, but also to everyone listening in live to the blessing. And with the apostolic blessing, today's general audience draws to a close. On behalf of Vatican Radio, I'd like to thank all of our partners who help make these live broadcasts available throughout the world, especially Luminous Radio at Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, Radio Maria England, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, Atmadarshan TV, EWTN TV, and Catholic TV. Thank you to our partner stations. Thanks, too, to our producers and technicians here in studio who make these broadcasts possible. And thanks to all of you for joining us today. For full coverage of today's audience, as well as other news from the Vatican and around the world, We invite you to visit the Vatican News web portal, that's www.vaticannews.va, as well as our Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube accounts. I'm Christopher Wells, and it's been a great pleasure providing coverage of today's journal audience. Praise be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.